Hey y'all, I am back in my spot, same spot, hasn't changed. I may have taken a YouTube break, but my YouTube videos haven't changed. Actually, me and Paul did make a video together, which not sure exactly when it'll be out, if it'll be before this or after this, but really excited about that. We made two together, one for his channel, one for mine. And it was really funny. He's like, do your intro. And then I was just like, hey y'all. So it's officially my intro. He does a really kind of fun one, and he like stands in front of the camera and then the other person stands back, and then he does it like very Gary V-esque, and I'm just not that cool. So hey y'all, like an idiot will continue to be my intro. But I will explain what I'm gonna be talking about today. So been really MIA, like I said, prep really got busy, and all my other social media kind of took a hold, and not the YouTube videos because of the editing process. It's just like, to me, I know it's really not that hard, but you know, there's just certain things that you rather do, and it's easier for me to post on Instagram than it is to edit a YouTube video. But me and Ryan came up with a whole list of really cool videos, so I'm excited to talk about these topics because I know that they do help people out, and I just want to share the content, spread the love. That was so ridiculous. Anyways, so today I want to talk about my trip to Italy in regards to the food aspect. So for anyone who is following my prep journey, I competed at the San Marino Pro, which is in San Marino, Italy, a really, really tiny town in northern Italy. So when you travel internationally, you know, you never really know you're going to respond to, you know, the flight, and it was a long flight, and you know, just whatever, and you want to get acclimated, you want to get there, and you want to train, and then also, you know, the time change and the sleep, but also really importantly is, you know, what if your plane gets delayed and, you know, something like crazy happens with the connector and then you're stuck somewhere and you never get to the show. So, you know, we really made it a priority to get there early. I always try to get there early for the shows, but particularly for the for that show also. So it was me and Mom, we went, it was a full week, and the first half was before my competition and the second half was after and fun. So they drastically were very different as far as my energy levels, as far as my priorities. If anyone followed my Snapchat, I was basically just, you know, the massive fat foodie. So I want to kind of go into that because a lot of people I know are, you know, scared to travel on prep. And they think they can only be in their little box, or you know, they kind of like fall off the deep end when they travel, and they don't think that they can, you know, handle staying on track, even if you're not prepping, just, you know, staying mindful. And then the other side of the spectrum is that some people are too afraid to eat, and then they, you know, they don't really experience their vacations because of that. So I kind of wanted to go through my process, how I did things, why I did them, and maybe that will help you for a future trip that you do. And let me just comment that I am so pale. This is so alarming, and I know I always try to wear black because I'm super emo, but this is just too much. I really need this is my wake-up call to put some more pro tan on, because we know I'm not gonna go out in the sun. Anyways, so trip to Italy. First we left from, so San Marino, like I said, is a really small town in northern Italy, and there's not even like an airport to get there, so it was extremely confusing. And it was really actually hard to plan for. But we left from Miami to Madrid, Madrid to Bologna. Stayed the night in Bologna, and then we were gonna take a car service, or you could take a train to San Marino. So the trip from Miami to Madrid was very long, obviously. but it you know, it works out well because usually the international flights are later. So I had pretty much had about, I had three of my meals, I think, two or three of my meals beforehand, and then I basically brought the rest of my day's calories, you know, for that day in that flight. And then, you know, was going to try to sleep, but, you know, sleeping on planes sucks. Especially when you can already barely sleep on prep, sleeping on a plane is not the best. But anyway, so I was super prepared that day, had my numbers to a T, no issues, because I had all my food. The biggest thing is water when traveling for me, because I do have such a high fluid intake. I drink on prep typically about 2 gallons total. That's everything. Like, that's just water, that's my pre-workouts, that's my coffee, like that's everything. But I drink about 2 gallons of fluid, so it, you know, it's definitely challenging when you're traveling and you can't bring, you know, a gallon of water on an airplane. So I very, very nicely have to ask the flight attendants to give me like the big liters, and you know, not really supposed to do that, but, or, you know, and if they couldn't do that, then I would just have them refill it. It'd be really annoying. Like, hey, I want 3 waters. It just kind of is what it is. I don't really get embarrassed by that kind of stuff because I don't really care. I've dieted for like 7.5 months for this. I'm going to drink my water and I'm going to keep asking for water. So if you're somebody like that, really don't be embarrassed. It's not that serious. Just ask for water. Do what you need to do. Walked up and down the aisles, you know, go to the bathroom, you know, whatever. So we land in Madrid, which happens to be the biggest airport I have ever been in. If anyone's ever been there, you know what I'm talking about. We landed late. And then we literally did not stop moving. Did not stop moving. From the time we landed to the time we had to get through security. And then by the time we got there, we were gonna have to board the next plane. Like, it was nuts. So at this point, it's the middle of the night for my body because of the time change. So I'm like all out of sorts. It's like, you know, 2:30 a.m. to me, you know, walking around the airport trying to like, you know, carry all of our shit. Of course, you know, me and mom have 80 bags because that's just how we travel. And, you know, I didn't have, originally, you know, I had thought I was going to have to go through some sort of customs in Madrid. Thankfully, I didn't. And they were going to check your bag and take your food. And that does happen in certain countries. Like, Australia is really, really strict about what you can bring in as far as, like, food and everything. And then I had heard that going to the show that it wasn't going to be as strict. But I didn't want to bring food and then I go to waste and then just thrown away. So I packed, you know, things that weren't going to go bad. Why did I do this? Non-perishables. Things are going to go bad. Non-perishables. And so I had to get on our next flight, and I had about like this much water left because I didn't have time to fill it up or get new water. I had about this much water, and I had 2 pieces of untoasted Ezekiel bread, which anyone who's had that is, it's disgusting, with 2 packets of tuna. And it was like literally, it was like the first thing in the morning. I was like gagging it down. It was so gross, but you know, I needed to eat. And I didn't want to bring food and it get thrown away. So that was gonna hit my numbers. At this point in prep, I was eating a little bit more carbs and just kind of more moderate, lower fat. So that was perfect. So once we go on that small flight from Madrid to Bologna, which is when I had my nasty, nasty meal. Then we took a car to the hotel and just died. Just totally passed out. Sleeping is super important for your physique also. So anytime that I was really tired, I was like, just take a nap. I'm gonna look better. And then I believe I had like, at some point I had a Quest bar or something, either before or after the nap, not really sure. Woke up from my nap, felt really good, took progress pictures. Was really, really happy with where I was at actually after like all that long traveling and everything. And then, so again, at this point, I only had like 1 more tuna packet, Ezekiel bread, and some like beef jerky, and I don't cut sodium, so it was fine. And so basically I had that. And so at this point, I'm pretty hungry, because it's like all the food, you know, that I had brought. And I knew that we were gonna have to go and get food other places, and to most people, this would be causing like a major anxiety attack, but I really wasn't concerned because I've eaten out my entire prep. Now, eating out in Italy is a little bit different than eating out in America. There are less choices. You know, most notably the language barrier, you know, clearly is a problem. And particularly in other countries, it's almost looked at as like a slap in the face if you don't eat their food the way that they cook it. And I was like, no, it's not that. Like, I just can't have this. Some people didn't seem to understand that. Luckily, we did go to dinner with one of my mom's friends, and they're Italian, obviously, so they could kind of translate for me what I wanted, what I needed, which was perfect. And it ended up being, I could have a good sized meal because I, you know, my day was really weird and my calories were kind of all over the place. So I had a good meal, and I pretty much try to stick to the same foods when I'm prepping towards the end. Chicken, steak, potatoes, Ezekiel bread, some vegetables. You can't go anywhere and like not find, you know, steak, chicken, and potatoes. You know, like that's literally everywhere, vegetables, like, you know, so for me it was really easy. My body was already used to eating that food, and then the only thing that you have to worry about is if they cook it in a certain way with certain oils, certain butter, you know, whatever. Again, in another country, kind of difficult to be like, no oil. They, you could say that. Sometimes it worked. Sometimes it didn't. And then I just basically would just like adjust. If I can tell if something has oil on it or if something is cooked dry. So basically what I would do is that I would just, for that day, I didn't care because I needed more fats. My steak was cooked completely dry. I could taste it. The vegetables were fine. They were grilled. And then the potatoes had some olive oil on them. So again, not a big deal because I'd already, I needed that fat. So I knew that when I could either have fat at dinner or I could go home and have like some nut butter if I needed it. That morning, I ate breakfast at the hotel and then I had lunch before we got on the car ride to San Marino. So two meals out. Again, all my meals I'm eating out for a few days before a show. So it's totally possible. I got eggs, egg whites, vegetables, and again, I brought my own Ezekiel bread because I knew like that was super easy for breakfast and stuff, and tuna, which I already ate all of that. So I had that for breakfast, super easy, good to go. They don't really eat eggs over there for breakfast, so it was definitely like a weird when I was asking for it. But another different cultural thing, but I got the eggs, they were fantastic. Every egg was like orange red. It was so happy. I don't know how they don't eat eggs for breakfast when the eggs look like that. It was like so, it's like heartbreaking. I wanted to like bring all the eggs. I'm wearing my eggs in lecture, and clearly I'm obsessed with eggs, especially eggs in other countries because they look so much better than ours. Then we found a little cafe that honestly looked like it wouldn't have had anything, but they actually had grilled chicken and potatoes. Again, my go-to meal, and typically I was keeping it with chicken like when I was out, just in case, again, stuff was cooked in oil and whatever. So perfect. Good to go. Had that meal, had a Quest bar on the ride over. It was about, I can't even remember now, but it was a good while. I fell asleep at some point. Classic. I just fall asleep anywhere. but we get there, and then one of the big pros of finally being to San Marino was that hotel had a competitor's menu, which I knew was going to be like, you know, boring bodybuilder food, but that was perfect. So I knew bologna was gonna be the only time that was really a questionable, and it was. You know, I literally had to eat out for all of my meals, and I made it work, no issues. I brought a little bit of food, like non-perishable stuff, but I would encourage anyone, you know, don't really worry about it. It's not that serious. You know, you can find like chicken and steak and potatoes and things like that and vegetables wherever you're going, eggs. And even if it's hard to order, like it was hard to order, like, but you just have to do it because at the end of the day, like I said, I've been dieting for all this time and you know, whatever. So could I have brought food and maybe it would have gotten past because they didn't check anything at when I got to Bologna. I mean, I literally could have brought a whole cow in my suitcase. They wouldn't have cared. But I didn't know that, and I would hate for anyone to bring food and then it go to waste, right? So that's just my tips as far as when you're traveling before you get to your destination. If you are competing at a show, typically a lot of the shows will have these bodybuilder menus to cater to people's needs because they do know, especially in other countries, like people come from all over to travel and to compete. I mean, of course they come all over from, I'm not dieting anymore, but I still say dumb shit like that. People come from all over to compete, so they have to cater to that. So it was really nice. It's called takeaway in other countries. So I just get my takeaway meal of grilled chicken, boiled potatoes. They had rice, but I'm not as big a fan of rice as I am potatoes. So I ate a lot of chicken and boiled potatoes. Again, just to keep it super simple, and I didn't want to worry about it. I also brought rice cakes for the show. So I had that. I also brought nut butter because I always have that. And I brought it in like the Justin's package because I'm not going to bring like a whole jar. What if that blows up or something? Nightmare. We get to San Marino. I meet some friends and, well, I made friends. And then we went to train. There was actually a gym right nearby. So went and trained. They had the bodybuilder menu. Like everything is good to go. The following day is, you know, the day of just like running around for me. Like I go get my hair washed, I get my tans, I go to the athlete meeting. Like there's like all these things, you know, that are happening. And I mean, I'm just exhausted. Like traveling is hard enough. Prepping is hard enough. Traveling internationally and prepping is just really exhausting. So, you know, at that point when I, you know, I'm just trying to chill the day before, you know, do my little pump up routines, you know, posing, stuff like that. But I'm just really trying to relax, trying to sleep. And there was really not much stress besides, you know, I have to get the taxi and everything. And I actually had to like walk to my hair place because it was really close, but everything's like up on a hill in San Marino. There's like not really sidewalks. So I'm like trekking up the hill to like look at my hair wash. But they were great. Everything was awesome. And the show was actually on Sunday, which is very normal for European shows, which was weird for me. I was like, oh, this is so strange. But so that was Saturday for me. You know, all my meals were there. No issues. Again, eggs were fantastic. Oh, I just love the beautiful eggs in other countries. You guys are very, very lucky. If any people watching my YouTube videos are from you know, another country, a lot of them have amazing eggs, and I want to travel just to eat egg. No, really. So yeah, so I had all that stuff, you know, and again, all those meals are eating out, and you know, no issues. It was my best physique to date, actually. So day of the show, I had all my normal show day foods. So typically for the show days, I'll have whole eggs. Surprise, I'll have eggs and rice cakes. And then my next meals will either be chicken and steak or potatoes, chicken or steak, and then potatoes or rice cakes. You know, I usually throw a nut butter there, and I always have a peanut butter cup before I go on stage. Obviously, it's my thing, along with my wine. Those are just like non-negotiables. Like, I have a peanut butter cup and I have my wine. I don't care. I have rituals. It's part of my rituals. So again, I had brought the rice cakes, the peanut butter, the peanut butter cups, and then everything else was purchased at the show. And no issues. It was actually, you know, again, the language barrier can be difficult sometimes, but they were very accommodating. And the two friends that I did meet, one of them, he was from Italy. They currently live in the UK, but he obviously speaks Italian. So that was really, really helpful, particularly when we were at like restaurants and things like that. So show day of the show stuff was exactly the same, except so it was cold and no humidity. So my hair looked fabulous. And my tan didn't like get sweaty because, you know, I mean, my armpits still sweat because I'm a sweaty person, but it was amazing. And I did my hair and makeup. I usually do that. Sometimes I'll have my hair done, sometimes I'll have my makeup done, but I usually will do it. And I again, with the language barrier, I was not gonna run the risk of that. I'm very particular. I'm sure you guys noticed. So I like everything just how I like it. And that's why I've kind of perfected my stage look. If I can get help from people I trust, great. If not, I can do it myself. And my hair usually gives me trouble because of the humidity, and it's just like, but over there, it was cold, no humidity, perfect. Or as Paul would say, if you're watching Paul, you're gonna laugh. He does this a lot, and it's just funny. He's like, perfect. So the show went great. For anyone who followed, I'll kind of put a picture here. Bam. Maybe, if I know how to do that. otherwise, you're gonna see my hand doing this. And I, you know, bought my best package, Protan, the German team. I'm sponsored by Protan, if anyone knows. And the Protan Germany team came there, and I was assured by everyone over here that they were good, and it was fantastic. The color was phenomenal. And again, maybe it was because it was cold and everything was dry, like, I'm not really sure, but I got so dark, but it still had that, like, Protan look. So it was just like, ugh. Amazing. So the whole package came together. It was my best physique to date. I came in full but tight. And yeah, like the whole everything was great. I felt really confident with my posing. I placed 7th. So not my best showing of the year, actually my worst placing of the year. But you know, it's that comes with the territory. So it was my best package. I was very happy I did it. And then that night we actually went out, to a family style Italian meal, which was super fun. I met up with some other friends who I didn't even really expect to be there, made some new friends. So it was really, really fun. And we of course had fabulous food. So you're watching this and you're listening to me talk about, I'm eating my chicken and my boiled potatoes and some olive oil here and there. And it's all the same stuff I'd be doing here, right? And that was because I had my show, and I'm very goal driven, and anyone who competes knows this, obviously. You know, of course I wanted to eat the other food while I was there, but you know, it didn't really even faze me because I knew, like, okay, I'm gonna compete in a few days, so it's really like a non-issue to me. But I'm also a massive foodie. Anyone who knows me knows that. And if you followed my snaps, you definitely know that. So I actually didn't even take my phone out the night after the show. I was just kind of like enjoying myself. I didn't even snap that, which I should have probably because it was so good, but you know, regardless, I was just there for the experience and talking with everyone. But so as soon as the show was over, I was like, okay, I'm in Italy. We're in San Marino this night, and then we were going to Rome the next day for 2 days. I'm just gonna have fun. Like, I, you know, to me, you know, maybe that's not the best thing to do metabolically, right? We all kind of know that, immediately going to overfeeding, but that's just, I'm not gonna miss out on my life, for maybe gaining some weight, right? And my metabolism actually was in a pretty good place, leading up to the show. I was eating probably the most calories that I ever had, being that lean. So that was pretty exciting. I kind of reversed into it, but I really didn't, but I kind of did. I just kind of was just playing around different things, and I would just add a little bit of carbs here and there, and I just seemed to really respond to that. So yeah, it was a semi-reverse, but it wasn't really structured. It was kind of day by day. How do I look? How do I feel? And every day was kind of different. But I knew I'm gonna be in Italy, and I love eating, and I love drinking, so I'm just gonna do that. So I think it's really important to, and even though those are two really drastically different things, and we always try to talk about having like balance, that's a balance to me. I have to be really strict on prep, because, you know, it's prep and I'm gonna be on stage. But to a lot of people, they would not have been able to handle the flexibility of that. Is my straw in the jaw? Sorry, my straw. Isn't it so cute? Okay, sorry. Squirrel. A lot of people wouldn't have been able to handle eating out all those meals, and they would have freaked out. But why? You know what you're eating. If you really do know, you know, I know people on meal plans who are eating that food too, you know, so it's, you know what's in the food, and, you know, even if it's challenging, ask for it to be cooked a certain way. And then if it comes out not cooked a certain way, then you just accommodate and you change things up later. That's why I stuck to things that I know, chicken and steak and potatoes and vegetables. Good to go. Eggs, I brought my Ezekiel, I brought my rice cakes, and I just kept it really simple. But I was still able to travel across the world without any food, or, I mean, a little bit, and still managed to get on stage and look my best. Now, on the flip side, I also know how to, like I said, want to enjoy food, want to enjoy the experience. Anyone who's been to Italy, they're obviously really into food. So it was perfect for me. And my mom was dying because she's not really a big eater like I am. And I can really throw down some food. So it was really exciting. And I think it's important to kind of highlight that. Like, I went to Rome, and, you know, that night after the show, and I enjoyed myself, and I wasn't freaking out about, like, you know, oh my gosh, this and that, what's in here? Like, I was trying new foods. And yeah, I came back and I, like, obviously gained weight, and I was super bloated and, like, uncomfortable. And then I was, like, bitching about that. Of course, because we're girls, that's what we do. But then, you know, a few days after, things kind of normalized. Like, I was back to my normal training, back to my normal food, back to my normal water amount. That was the hardest thing, was like, oh my God, it was like, getting water over there is like a sacred resource, and you have to buy water everywhere, or it comes in like a little cup like this. I'm like, okay, I need a lot more than this. So once I was back on my normal hydration, and training and moving around schedule, you know, everything was really good. But I do want to take the time to talk a little bit about my foodie adventures for anyone who's listening who, you know, likes this kind of stuff. As you can tell, I have a huge smile on my face because I'm just remembering all this stuff. But yeah, Italy has great food. Obviously. And one thing that's really weird about me, people might not know on here, is I don't like cheese. And I know that's really strange, and everyone loves cheese, like, besides me. But, so there's a lot of cheese and stuff, but, you know, you can definitely work around it. And, you know, yeah, we just tried so much different food everywhere, and I love, love, love sweets. Like, dessert is my jam. And everywhere you go, there's gelato and espresso. So it's just like my two favorite things, like, put together everywhere. So it was a really, really cool experience. Like, me and mom did the whole sightseeing thing. We were walking around a ton, which definitely helped with all the eating. And we walked everywhere. We saw a lot of stuff. I mean, there's so much there. It was really cool to see all the things that have been there for 80 million years. Not really, but 2,000 years, and try all the new foods, and for somebody who does enjoy food like I do, trying new stuff like that was really exciting. The wine was great. I had lots of really good wines. My new favorite is, oh my gosh, what is it called? Oh, hold on, pause. I literally had to pause the video because this is so good and I had to share it. We tried this in, well, mom tried this in Bologna with her friends. They said that this was something that was, you know, local to their area. And then she found this at Trader Joe's. So it's only $5.99 a bottle for anyone who likes wine. This is like turned into like the foodie and wine video, but it's called Lambrusco. And this is what it looks like. And it's at Trader Joe's, and it's pretty phenomenal. So to wrap it up, Go try that. No, but most importantly, I wanted to really talk about this video to talk about the extremes of the prep. I mean, the extremes of the trip and how you really can balance prep and enjoy yourself. So this is not just talking to people who are dieting for a long time, going to an international show, and then exploring afterwards. This is for anyone, anywhere. The main takeaways are, one, no matter where you are, you can make it work, right? I've proven that to myself, this prep, and I've really tried to ingrain that into my clients, you know, whenever they ask me about stuff with traveling and whatnot. And a lot of people travel, like that's just kind of what we do. And I went a lot of places this prep, a lot of places where there was healthy, you know, food. Like if you go out west, it's pretty easy to travel, pretty easy to eat good. And then I've been, you know, to Italy, to New Orleans, like, you know, there's other places that are more challenging to eat. So I think it's really important to be able to stick to your goals and to trust yourself. A lot of it comes down to when you're at a restaurant, you're given a menu and you're given choices. And you can make the choice to either get something that you know is something that fits within your, you know, daily ranges, your daily targets. You know, you can ask the waitress or waiter, you know, hey, can you cook this like this, you know, whatever. So you know that you have that choice. But on the flip side of that, also know that you can enjoy yourself and you don't have to say, no, I can't go out to eat because I don't know what's there, or, oh, I can only order the plain chicken and the broccoli and I can only have like a side salad of something. No, no, no. There is a time and a place. You know, if you're traveling somewhere and you're still trying to stick to your goals, you know, definitely, you know that that's gonna be like a loosely tracked trip maybe. If you're not dieting, if you're not dieting, you can have a loosely tracked trip. It's not gonna like ruin your progress for the rest of your life, right? So know that you can say, okay, I'm gonna have most of my meals be moderate, try little things here and there, but then enjoy like one meal, right? Or, you know, be like me. And it, like my trip was extreme because I had a really extreme beginning of the trip, you know, okay, I need to make sure I eat my chicken and my potatoes and my whatever. And then afterwards I was like, you know what, I don't want to do that anymore. And I made that choice. Could I have made healthier choices while we were away? Yes, because I had done it the whole other part of the trip, but I didn't want to. So it's all a choice. Remember that. Anytime you sit down at a restaurant or you're with your family or you're going somewhere on a business trip, like there are choices. If you are trying to stick to your goals more closely, always bring things that, you know, you can pack, non-perishable goods. Nobody wants to eat. I wouldn't suggest eating dry tuna on dry Ezekiel. That's a little extreme. But, you know, you can have protein powder, you know, protein bars, beef jerky, you know, things like that, that, you know, you can have. So, you know, okay, at least I got my protein in. Like, I can have 2 scoops of protein powder. I'm good to go. And then you can have, you know, try smaller portions of meals. This probably sounded like a ramble. I know I got like really intense about this because I'm really, really passionate about people being able to balance things. Like, don't think that you can only ever eat one thing off of a menu or you can't go at all. But also at the same time, you know, you can balance things and you don't have to go full balls to the walls every time you go to a restaurant. Like, just because you're out of your kitchen doesn't mean that all of a sudden you forget about your goals. It's always about a balance. And hopefully, as usual, this video turned into kind of me being crazy and a little bit of a ramble, but I hope the message is still clear that you can balance both things and it's always your choice. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I promise to be back more regularly.